I tried every single diet you can imagine, from paleo to keto to I've been doing slow carb diet for most of the last 3-4 years, intermittent fasting. There's a lot of stuff, but at the end of the day, you need to choose something that you're, you know, you need to look forward to the food that you eat, not just because it tastes good, but also how it makes you feel.
Welcome to Forever Young, the health podcast from Lanzerhof. My name is Niels Behrens, and I'm not looking for eternal youth. I'm trying to find answers to what leading a healthy life really means. Therefore, I will be talking to various health experts to find out what you can do to stay fit for as long as possible. And who knows, perhaps this knowledge will help lead you to a longer life after all. Do you take supplements? Do you take vitamin D, for example? And if so, why? And how much? And do you even need it? I think everybody knows vitamins are important. But defining the right dose, the one that's right for you personally, is not easy. Therefore, I've invited an expert today who has already gone through this process and has not only solved his personal problem, but also founded a company out of it. My guest today is Vadim Fedotov, co-founder of the health tech vitamin supplement brand Bionic Life. He started his career as a professional basketball player as well as a very successful digital media manager before turning his attention to physical health and well-being. Welcome, Vadim.
Hi, Niels.
So, Vadim, how did you get into the health tech industry? Being a professional athlete, then a manager, and now a vitamin guru, it's not exactly a consistent career.
Certainly, but I think anybody who has been interested in sports always looks into optimizing his performance. And then when you get into the corporate world, you're in this position where you're like, what can I do? How can I become better? You look for competition. And this is the thing that when they get a certain age, it's very funny, they become actually more active again. So why a lot of people start doing, you know, marathons or running 35, 40 and older is because they're looking for something to compete against themselves and others. So I still think that, you know, having a professional sports background has always pushed me somewhere towards the health sector. But yeah, I agree. It wasn't straightforward. After finishing my career, I went into the corporate. I went to the e-commerce for many years. I was, you know, heading up a Groupon in Russia and Ukraine, then went to the media. But while doing that, I realized that I am doing a lot of things to support myself during my corporate life, but those things don't really make a lot of sense to me because I don't know which one of them are actually, you know, having results. So the craziest part was at some point I would do 12 workouts per week. I would do keto diet, intermittent fasting, full day fasting. I would do probably supplementation of 20 to 25 different products, and I would still feel bad. I would still fall asleep. At 9 or 10 p.m., I would still be sloggy after lunch. I wouldn't have, you know, any energy to work out in the evening. And I was like, how can I do and spend so much time and money into, you know, pretending to support my health without seeing actually any results? And this is the moment where I decided, let me see if there's any company out there in the market where it allows you to track what's going on inside of your body, but not just track, because there's a lot of tracking out there, but actually give you, you know, personable solutions, how you can impact those tracking that you actually can have see a trend. And for my surprise, and I've traveled to, you know, to the US, to Germany, to the UK, to a lot of countries, I was not able to find a company that provided service at the level that I would expect that they should be out there. And this is when I realized there's a niche and there's a demand, and you know how they always say, scratch your own itch. And I decided to, you know, look into it and start scratching my own itch with Bionic. Obviously, I don't have a medical background and we're a health tech company. So the first thing before even doing anything is I went out and wanted to look for a partner, a co-founder with medical expertise, especially in the clinical trials sector. So I found my co-founder, Konstantin Karuzin, who is a neurosurgeon. He has a total of 25 years clinical trials for, you know, GlaxoSmithKline and Pfizer and the top brands in the world. And what he did, which was very interesting, over the last 9 years, his company was contracted to develop a system to improve cognitive and physical capabilities of professional athletes. So over a total of 8 years, he did clinical trials in Switzerland on, you know, thousands of athletes to see when they do regular blood checkups on tons of parameters, 180 to 250 different parameters, which of them, how change over time depending on the food and micronutrient consumptions that they do. And he was able to establish with a double-blind placebo-based studies that the impact of micronutrients on performance in terms of physical and also cognitive is significant, even in people who are at the maximum peak of their capabilities, like 25-year-old athletes. But then he started testing that on more regular average people, you know, 35, 40, 55-year-olds. And he saw that his improvements are not 8, 10, 12, but 30, 40, 50, 60% in terms of their performance levels after starting the program. And the program entails the following. A person does a at-home or at the office or at a clinic, does a blood checkup between 35 to 50 different blood parameters depending on the needs of the person. Then the system incorporates a survey of around 40 questions with prior histories, goals, family, health histories. And considering the information from the blood results, the survey, and an additional one-on-one consultation, this person then receives a plan going forward for nutrition, but most importantly also for micronutrients intakes. And those micronutrients intakes, he receives a two-month program totally personalized for him, for this person, on average around 50 different components in a granular form that allows to absorb most, you know, they actually allow to absorb on a much higher level than a pill form over a span of 12 hours. So by doing two intakes per day, this person is capable of fully supplying the daily need for this person. And the best thing about the system is it repeats itself every 2 months. So the person only gets exactly what he or she needs at this given moment, and he can see and track the improvement, which is exactly what I was looking for when I started Bionic in the market. Something that not just tells me what's going on today, but also tells me what I can do to improve tomorrow.
Excellent. So if you look at one of your typical clients, he is doing a blood test every other month, and after what period of time would you say he doesn't have any deficiencies? So, or is it a goal which is possible to reach, to don't have any deficiencies anymore?
Yeah, great question. So first of all, I want to share that in now already, you know, around 2 years of work and thousands of clients, we had two clients that came in with perfect results right away, and we basically said, here's your money back, you are in the ideal shape and form right now. There's nothing we can do to support you. Just keep on doing what you're doing. So those people exist. It's 0.01%, but they exist, and we're more than happy to, you know, to laud those people for their achievements in terms of their lifestyle. Then typically what you will see is that people reach a close to optimal level after 4 to 6 months, at which point they continue the system to maintain that level. So I get a lot of questions because based on, you know, historic views, when they hear about supplementation or vitamins, they think vitamins should take them in cycles, 2 to 3 months, because the body gets used to those vitamins, and then you're overdosing the body with something that the body doesn't need. And that's correct. You shouldn't take something without having a blood test analysis, understanding what your body needs at this given moment. So the best thing about the system is it always adjusts to you. So you can start with the system, and in the first 2 months, you have probably 55 to 60 components. And by month 8, you have only 20 to 25 components to just support the health at half the dosages that your body needs. So it's something that is part. When people ask me, how long should I plan on taking Bionic? My answer is, how long do you plan on eating healthy and sleeping well? And that mostly, you know, answers the question.
Exactly. This brings me to my next question. In the recent years, the reputation and usefulness of dietary supplements has deteriorated significantly. Would you say that's the reason, because it's not based on any examinations?
I mean, this is the reason. Listen, this is the reason why I'm sitting here where Bionic is doing. Listen, I was taking before Bionic 25 different, you know, bottles starting from zinc, magnesium to vitamin D, omega 3, you know, and then you start going down the line with all the other stuff that, you know, you think you need, B6, B9. Okay, I want to improve my brain function. And then you just keep on going. Oh, I just read online, you know, K2 is the new wonder vitamin. Let me add K2 to it. And then you go, vitamin C is so great. Everybody's been telling me vitamin C since my birth. So then you end up with a lot of stuff. The problem is you don't even know what you need. Like my magnesium levels were, I didn't need magnesium levels, the levels I was taking in. My zinc was fine. My iron level was low, but I had no idea about it, but I didn't take iron. You know, vitamin D, it says take vitamin D2 pills. Well, the problem is the vitamin D2 pills is 8,000 units per day. Unfortunately, considering my weight and my activity level, I need three times of that. Nobody would ever tell me to take three times the vitamin D levels because they would consider it dangerous unless they see my blood levels and see how I absorb things. So it's just very funny when my wife and I buy an omega-3 bottle and it says take two pills per day. Well, my wife weighs half my weight. Does she still have to take two pills per day? Or should she take one and I take two? Or should she take two and I take four? Or maybe her one and a half? Well, it's if one and a half. Should she cut the omega-3 pill? Well, you can't cut it. So the reason why people think so poorly about it is because one size can never fit all, but vitamins try to do that. And second thing, not everybody needs what you think you need. We had female customers coming in asking for vitamins that people need after the menopause because she read online that she needs that. Well, she's 25. She doesn't need a vitamin that people start taking after 40. And this is just something that, you know, people just get this impression that, oh my God, it will improve me. And then it doesn't improve them because their body, A, didn't need it, or even worse, can't handle it. And that's where you get these jokes about, you know, half of the vitamins you take in, you know, you urine out. This is where the stuff comes from, where people think so negatively about it. And the second thing is there's not enough clinical trials and proof. Vitamins in many major markets don't need approval from organizations in terms of what their standards from. The reason why we're using Swiss granules, because the quality of the Swiss ingredients is worldwide known that in Switzerland, the micronutrient level, the cleanliness and regulation on them is as high as on the pharmaceutical level. So you understand that the quality of the micronutrients is top level. So this is something that, you know, you would take, I would take, I would tell my parents to take, I would give my children to take, because you expect that kind of quality. When somebody else just doesn't really care too much about it and, you know, adds additional carbohydrates into it to increase the insulin level spike so it absorbs better, but forgets that the insulin spike is ruining the person's dietary plans. So there's a lot of stuff going on that people, you know, think negatively about because it makes sense. Because if you don't check it, you don't see that, then you can only hope for it. And I think it's a little bit expensive just to hope for results.
I could imagine. But this is a very interesting question. So you couldn't say that vitamin C you can buy everywhere is the same quality. So there's a reason behind it why different vitamins have different prices.
Oh, 100%. Because the ingredients and the quality that are being used, the factory that it's being used in, the pill form, the shell that it's being used for. I mean, again, you can have vitamin D's or omega-3, one of the best cases. Omega-3 is just because it says it has the same concentration of omega-3, depending on how it's being taken in, what the shell is like, the absorption will be much better. You can have half the dosage with the same result because just the quality of the absorption level is much higher. This is the reason why we're going the route of, you know, Swiss-based production, because we want to ensure that we know the dosage that you need and we want to make sure that the dosage you need is being absorbed best.
But is omega-3 also part of your formula? Because I always thought that omega-3 is something which has to be liquid.
So in terms of omega-3, omega-3 is because it's soluble. It's not in a bionics micronutrient formula. We see that around 65 to 70% of our clients, due to, for example, cholesterol levels, we recommend them omega additionally. So we then send them out recommendations what omega they can purchase locally, or we can send them additional omega-3 if they have the desire. So this is something that this is the reason why I'm telling you that it's important to also include things like omega-3 to support your health overall.
So just in general, I think there are a lot of people which are saying, at the end, you also could have a healthy diet. Why do you think that in general supplementation is so important in nowadays?
Because people are on the go. People are on the go. It's almost impossible. I'm not saying we would love for people to have a healthy diet. Bionic is something that, again, the idea was to create solutions. It's a personalized solution. This is a solution how even when you're on the go, even if you can't cook at home, even if you can't afford or don't have the time to buy the perfect ingredients at each and every time, this is how you can, you know, support your health by adding that. Because it's just time-wise, you will to hit the perfect diet will cost you just several hours per day, and you have to adjust it. With Bionic, it's, you know, a scoop in the morning, a scoop in the evening, and you're good to go on your micronutrients.
All right. I know that your approach is a bespoke approach, but would you say that you have a recommendation that there is a supplement that just everybody needs?
Yeah, so what we did is, and this is something that the market dictated to us, it was very interesting. When the pandemic started, a lot of our clients reached out to us and they're like, can you please help me? What should I buy my parents, or what should I buy my friends or family members that don't have access to Bionic for different reasons, because they live in different areas or it's just in terms of cost-wise? So we created a list of recommendations where we said there's a basic components, zinc, vitamin C, vitamin K2, vitamin D3, and antioxidants that you should intake to improve your immune levels. So there are basic fundamental mixes that we recommend people to take to have a general improved immune system to get through the day stronger. So yes, that is. Of course, those lack the personalized approach because it's more a high quality multivitamin per se. But there are certain things that we do recommend. Again, as I said, around more than two-thirds of the people we recommend take omega-3. And then, again, vitamin C, vitamin D, K2, zinc, and certain antioxidants to support your immune system.
Let's go back to this healthy diet. When you have to guess, what percentages can be achieved through a healthy diet and how much through supplements? So just percentage-wise.
Percentage-wise, healthy diet is at least 70%, at least 70%. Anybody who ever tried to lose weight and tried to do it by increasing sports realized that your body reacts to food first. So this is the most important part. Then in addition, then you the next thing what people underestimate, and I was the first one, and this is something that was very life-changing for me. There's a book called Why We Sleep by Matthew Walker. Probably one of the most life-changing books in my life that I read. I realized the importance aspect of, you know, regeneration of sleep, of giving your body the ability to recover, and just this focus aspect. So I would say food is number one, sleep is two, then the activity level and vitamins. So in terms of the vitamins approach, it's anywhere, depending on the person, up to, you know, 15 to 20% of overall achievement levels. But it's one of those things that if you eat right and sleep, then the vitamins can get you to the optimal stage. That's the very important part. So this is something that has the capability to really, you know, increase your level of stamina, of your performance, of your cognitive functions that otherwise you wouldn't achieve because you would always be a little bit lower in your performance levels because you wouldn't supplement personalize your desires and needs.
So to get the optimal level, maybe this question is more for someone with a medical background, but probably you have an idea. What would you say, to what extent does genetics play a role in the selection of supplements?
I mean, yes, of course. There's two approaches to this. If you're low in vitamin C in terms of your diet, then your genetics test will not help you. So this is, you know, this genetics is not capable of letting you know what you need. So we, like in terms of how Bionic works, we chose blood level tests because they're dynamically changing and you can see improvement. Your genes are, you know, your DNA test is one result that doesn't change over time. But what we do with genes, on the genetic level, you can see what kind of chronic, you know, capabilities a person has in terms of absorption levels or how he reacts to certain things, certain components. So we see DNA tests and genetics as something to better understand in case there are issues with someone, to adjust to the capabilities of this person. It's not something that you do. We do blood levels and supplement with genetics. We don't base it on genetics first. So this is where we see that the approach, genetics can be very useful once we realized that there's issues there on the genetic level. Me, for myself, for example, I had issues with my liver functions. It was very high. So for three tests in a row, I couldn't lower my bilirubin level, my liver levels. And then we did a DNA test and found out that on the genetic level, I have a defect, and that regardless of supplementation, I will not be able to fix that. The only way how I can fix that part was by adjusting my diet, by consuming less portion sizes during a single meal intake. And once I realized that part, that's when my liver value started improving. So this is where genetics is coming in. It's coming in when you realize that something is not reacting to your changes, micronutrients or activity level or food. And then you figure out on a more deeper level what's going on inside of your body.
Yeah, and you see, what for me, I also used your bionic subscription. And what I really found fascinating is how fast this improvement goes, and also just by changing some very easy things. So not only the supplementation. So for my, I think I had a lack of selenium, and so I got the recommendation to get to add a Brazil nut every day. So up to three every day, and after 1 month I didn't have the lack anymore. So which I really liked on the approach, that you can learn something and it is so easy to adjust. So this is what I really liked.
But very sorry, just simple test. For me, uric acid was high, and I'm like, oh, uric acid, it's probably you eat too much red meat. And I'm like, actually, I stopped eating red meat, it's still high. And they're like, well, do you eat spinach? I'm like, yes, I eat a lot of spinach. They're like, well, it must be the spinach. And the same thing, something for you, it's a Brazilian nut. For me, it's spinach. And you make that adjustment and your body starts feeling better.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So when you look at the science, there are always some new insights. And I have also the feeling that there are some trends. So I can remember when you were talking about the immune system, vitamin C was always the hero. Then after a while, zinc was added as a new recommendation, and that vitamin C without zinc doesn't make any sense. Now pandemic situation, a lot of people also say, yeah, but please also add vitamin D, which at the end is not really a vitamin, but nevertheless, vitamin D is now the next hero. And I would say recently spermidine has also been added, which is quite new from my point of view, but nevertheless, do you see that there are some new stars to boost your immune system? Is it also something you can observe already in your last 2 years?
100%. Again, K2, vitamin K was definitely one of the stars, upcoming stars from last year that prior nobody talked about. I think everybody now understands the research is just so overwhelmingly vitamin D is not just important, but also the dosages have to be much higher than prior thought. I think at the new European standard dosage for vitamin D is 10,000 units per day.
Really? 10,000 per day?
Yes.
I'm taking 20,000 per week.
And this is the thing, why people think that vitamins don't work. So you take 20,000 per week, and if you do a blood test, your vitamin D level will be probably around 25 to 35, which should be around 60. So, and you're like, well, I'm taking this vitamin D and my vitamin D is not going up. Well, I'm sorry, because I know you personally, my guess is that you should at least take 8,000, probably 10,000, because 10,000 is now the recommended dosages. And this is the thing. So for example, in some of our markets, one of our markets that we're in, the daily recommended dosage is 400 units, which is, I'm sorry, that's what, 25 times less than recommended dosage. And this is where people start to getting, you know, frustrated. I'm like, I'm buying vitamins, but I don't see or feel results. Well, I'm sorry, the dosages that have been recommended over the last 10 to 20 years, unfortunately, are not, you know, in line with the newest research that we have seen.
Okay. So my last question, do you have an advice for our listeners who want to find a nutritional balance in their life? So if they don't have access to Vionic, how would you recommend to start?
To be honest with you, probably for me, the pandemic, the one thing that has been crucial, I was literally able to do a little bit of clinical trials on myself because you have such a controlled living environment that I know exactly what I ate, I knew exactly what I added to the food, and I could see how my body reacts to that kind of food. So I've been, you know, training myself to see the reactions to it. I mean, anybody who you go out there, everybody will tell you, try to live moderate. The question is, what is moderate? And the question is also, what are you trying to achieve? Everybody says, listen to your body. And by listen to your body, actually what they mean to it, see how your body reacts. Do you feel bloated? Do you feel sleepy? How do you feel when you wake up out of bed in the morning? What's your reaction time? How much water intake are you keeping after having alcohol in the evening? There's all those things that people can start tracking now because, you know, of the new reality that we live in. And I think this is a huge progress. I now, for example, I tried to go a week without alcohol, and then I added 2 glasses of alcohol on a Friday. Next day I wake up and I weigh an extra kilogram and a half water weight because I didn't change my calorie intake. And I just see that my body is reacting differently to alcohol. You know, when you eat, I added, instead of olive oil, linseed oil. My body reacts a certain way where I'm just like, okay, linseed oil is not something that, you know, I'll react good to. So there's a lot of things that you can change. But number one thing is always listen to your body, because your body will let you know what you really need. Are you getting a rash? Are you getting, you know, sleepy? Are you getting something out of it? Just try to go in that path. But because in terms of nutrition and diets, there's a lot of diets out there. Again, I tried every single diet you can imagine, from paleo to keto to... I've been doing slow carb diet for most of the last 3-4 years, intermittent fasting. There's a lot of stuff, but at the end of the day, you need to choose something that you need to look forward to the food that you eat, not just because it tastes good, but also how it makes you feel.
Thank you very much, Vadim. This was very fascinating, and you for sure have convinced me to subscribe Bionic again. So I just had it as a test, but now I have the feeling that my future can't be without it. So thank you very much for this. And
thank you, Nils. Thank you.
Yeah, talk to you soon.
Awesome. Have a great day. Thank you for having me.
Thank you very much for listening. If you enjoyed it, please leave me a review and subscribe to this podcast. Please stay healthy. Just one last question. Do you personally still have any deficiencies, or are you 100% now?
And this is the funny thing. And this is the thing that where I'm the typical male client of Bionic. I'm the guy who, when I started the first 2 months, I was super into it, dedicated, looking into it. Saw the results, got additional boost. The second cycle, I'm like, oh my God, this is great. I'm really feeling it. It's great. And then your discipline level goes down because any human being has a discipline level. And then by the third, fourth cycle, so between month 6 and 8, you know, I start, you know, skipping Bionic, not listening less to my nutritionist. So you're still a human being. You're still not a robot. So you go through those phases. Right now, I'm in a very good phase. I just got my results. I think my cholesterol level could be a little bit lower, but everything else is in a very, very optimal stage. My vitamin D is finally good. Everything is good. But again, this is when you asked, you will never be optimal for a long enough level to not need to control and look after you. You will always have those phases where you just need an additional support function, or a person who will tell you, listen, give this a thought. So you will go through it. So as of today, I'm in a very good place. But again, I don't think that, you know, our current life that we're living in is standard, because now we have more time, travel less, and we can focus more on our body. But hey, 2 months from now, if we travel again or do other things again, and, you know, we'll probably get my results and I'll have more deficiencies because I didn't take care of my body enough, like as I should. So the answer is yes, there's always something to work on.